have all three competitors back on the stage, please. Excellent competition, very solid. Judges, our first competitor scores for Mr. Cody Wilson. Score? 9.98, 9.99, 9.98, 9.98, and 9.99 for Cody Wilson. Mr. Brett Ford, judges score? 9.99, 9.98, 9.99, 9.97, and 9.97 for Brett Ford. And scores for Mr. Michael Smith. Score? 9.97, 9.97, 9.97, 9.99, and 9.98 for Michael Smith. All three of these guys were awesome. Today, MTN Forbes Black Belt Men's Grand Champion, Mr. Cody Wilson.
I'm not gonna make you look bad, I promise, guys. Alright, so I've actually seen Cody a lot at Joey Perry's studio, and I think you have more energy than most of the 5 and 6 and 7 year olds.
It's all pretend, I promise you. I'm dying on the inside.
Is that true? Okay. Now, I don't know if everybody knows this, but I was told that you have a nickname that you're kind of known by. Can we share that with the audience tonight?
I can already tell who to blame, but go ahead.
Who do you think is to blame for this?
My mom.
So your nickname is?
Ginger Ninja.
The Ginger Ninja, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations.
Great job, Mr. Wilson. All right, and straight to our next judges. This is a 13 and under intermediate advanced weapons grand championship. There are two competitors. First up, from Jonesboro, Arkansas, representing Joey Perry Martial Arts. You watched him earlier in the empty hand forms. Now he's back for weapons. Give it up for Mr. David Hernandez. get both of these young men back on the stage, please. Joey, just center area. Cody, right up there on the black, sir. Cody. We got to get the scores, dude. All right, scores are first up for David Hernandez. Judges score, 9.99, 9.99, 9.98, 9.99, and 9.99 for David. And judges scoring for Mr. Cody, 9.98, 9.98, 9.99, 9.98, and 9.98 for Cody Taylor. All right, and your grand champion, Mr. David Hernandez. Yeah, you gotta hit the gauntlet. That was awesome. All right.
David, how do you feel after that win here tonight?
Amazing.
All right, cool. Well, congratulations. I love the fact that you have that. I was thinking, because I'm kind of getting hungry. I'm sitting here thinking, I gotta eat something, but junk food sounds good to me too, right? You like junk food? Would you even eat a candy bar?
Yes.
What kind of candy bar would you eat?
M&M's.
M&M's? Peanuts? Or just the regular?
Regular.
A regular M&M's, right there. Congratulations, David.
All right. We have an exhibition. This will not be scored, and then we'll go right back to scoring. This young man was a winner. His competition did not be here this evening, so we're letting him perform some earlier. 14 to 17 intermediate advanced weapons, one of the divisional winners from American Karate, Zurich, Dominic Lancaster. Dominic, don't run off anywhere because I've got to get you one of these goblins, man. He automatically wins one. You guys give him another round of applause, please. Our grand champion, 1417 weapons coming up, Mr. Dominic Lancaster. He's 14, but he's taller than me. Oh, and you get to be interviewed real quick.
Yeah, I mean, I have to interview people, right? That's kind of like my gig tonight. How do you feel?
Good.
All right, so if we're going to go and do, I don't know, let's say we're going to go out to a fast food restaurant. Do you eat junk food?
Yes.
What's your favorite restaurant to go to?
Chick-fil-A.
That's good, though, right? That's good food. What about music that we would find? What's your favorite, and who's your favorite artist?
Bless and Drake.
Congratulations. Congratulations, Grand Champ.
I wasn't ready for the chili peppers. That's a good choice. Not bad. All right. Our next division is a black belt weapons division, and I'm going to mix it up a little bit. Is there a taking an extra little sec? Can I have Master Kramer down, please? Few of our amazing judges that haven't judged yet tonight, because they're going to judge this last half one, a few divisions. Even if they said they were embarrassed, no, they're not embarrassed. They're just giving them a hard time. All right, ready to go? Scorekeepers, competitors, we're good? Outstanding. Judges, musical chairs, outstanding. Here we go. This is 13 and under. Black belt weapons winners. We have three competitors for this division. And first up, all the way from South Carolina, you saw him earlier, Mr. Ben Jones.
Judges, I am Peter Jones, the judge of Mr. Jane again.
Chris Gray, representing White Belt Karate out of Missouri. Watched him earlier. He's back. Chase, young one. Young work. All right, I can have all three competitors back on the stage, please. Excellent job. First up for scoring is Mr. Ben Jones. The judges score 9.98, 9.97, 9.98, 9.99, and 9.97 for Ben Jones. Jerry Jones, no relation. Judges, score? 9.99, 9.99, 9.99, 9.97, 9.98. And last to be scored is Mr. Chase. Judges, score? 9.97, 9.98, 9.97, 9.98, and 9.99. Chase. And your grand champion winner is Kira Jones.
Kira, congratulations. How do you feel? Good. All right. You tired? Worn out?
Very much so.
Been a long day?
Yes.
If you could meet anybody famous, any celebrity, who would you want to meet?
Myself.
Meet yourself. Future celebrity, future Hall of Famer, great champion for sure. Congratulations.
All right, next up, I need my five judges to the stage, please. And if these two competitors, Riley and Mishka, have their coaches to the stage. This is the 15 to 17 open weight girls division.
Mr. Osborne, come on up.
Good evening, Miss Riley and Miss Michigan. Two competitors tonight, representing Team Heartland out of Tennessee, is Riley Rhodes. There you go with that. And representing Team Heartland also out of Missouri, is Michigan Pentecost. So, just a moment real quick while they're getting that readjusted. Once again, we want to thank everybody for supporting ProMac and our movement, what we're doing. I'm getting a lot of great feedback from everybody. But some people don't know, they don't know, you know, how that all got kicked off. It was kind of one of the brainchilds. So, if you guys do not know, Mr. Greg Ruth was kind of responsible for spearheading that and getting that going and moving forward. And he's also the owner and promoter of the Battle of Atlanta, which is now going to have its 50th event. So that's a heck of an achievement. It's absolutely amazing. That tournament has been really kind of going in an amazing direction. I'm glad to be a small part of that. And if you guys are martial arts scholars involved with getting the Century MA Success magazine this month, the new cover of MA Success is promoting the Battle of Atlanta and representing the Battle of Atlanta, and Mr. Greg Ruth is on the cover of that. So congratulations, Mr. Ruth. And if you guys haven't, you know, given him some love, make sure you guys do that. Thank you, sir. All right, we're ready to go. It was perfect. It's almost like we planned that. Perfect timing. I love it. All right, we're ready to go, sir. Michigan, 5-2, 45 seconds left. 1 point, Michigan, 5-3, 40 seconds. 1 point, Riley, 6-3, 10 seconds. 1 point, Riley, 7-3. 2 points, Michigan, and time. That was an excellent ladies' fight. And your winner, Miss Riley Rhodes.
So you don't have to even leave the house to go to school. That's good. Okay, so you're doing the school, you do the training. Outside of that, I'm sure that keeps you pretty busy. What's your favorite thing to do other than the school you're training?
I like to go around. I train with a system called United, and I go around to their schools in southern Georgia, and I like to go train with them. They're real nice people.
Awesome. Congratulations. Grand champion.
All right, we're going to keep fighting one more division. Should be good. This is the men's 18-plus openweight finale. The winner of this does not get a glove, but they do get $200 cash. Earlier today, we fought the men's regular division fighting grand championships. The winner of that got the glove. The openweight gets the money today. So here we go. Representing Missouri, Mr. Brett Ford. Representing Kentucky, Mr. Christopher Victory. Should be a good one. Let's do it. Judges are doing Forbes Division next. And your winner of the weight challenge, Mr. Brett Ford. You guys give him one more round of applause. Great job, Brett. Great job, Mr. Victor.
$200 for what you just now did. What do you think you'll do with that $200?
gotten my nose for these games.
Are you gonna go on team?
Probably. I'm probably paying for that.
What about new gear? You think you're thinking?
Could afford to get new spirits. So.
Well, congratulations. You are a great champion.
All right, we only have a couple of more left for the evening. Thank you guys for supporting these guys. These two are going to be entertaining, so you will enjoy them. You will be entertained. Our next division is the 14 to 17 year old black belt weapons division, and all three of these competitors represent three different states, and they are all just killing on the regional and national circuit. So we're happy to have them on stage tonight. Your first competitor from right here in Jonesboro. You saw him earlier in Empty Hands. Now you get to see what he can do with the weapon. Please give a round of applause for PJ Clark. Mr. PJ Clark. Next up, representing Tennessee, you also saw him earlier in Empty Hands, Mr. Dawson Holt. Always giving the respect. Love it. Thank you. Looks like Bob gets to get you a new sword too, right? Great job, Dawson. And our last competitor, coming to us all the way from South Carolina, representing Competitive Edge, and Premier, Mr. Aaron Henson, Mr. Winston Jones.
Congratulations. How do you feel after that performance?
It's actually pretty good, sir.
Has it been a long day for you two?
Yes, sir.
Let's talk about your training. How long have you actually been working with Joey Perry at the studio?
For about 6.5 years.
Wow, that's a long time, isn't it? What's so cool about using this weapon? What do you like the most about it?
I feel like you can be really unique with your striking, and I feel like it's just like a good weapon to use for power.
Cool. So one of the big movies out right now is Avengers Infinity War. Have you seen it yet? Yeah, but if you were going to be a superhero, you could be any superhero for a day, who would you choose?
Superman.
Superman right there, your grand champion, PJ, congratulations.
Alright, congrats PJ. I'm telling you, when he was little, it was the Jerry Maguire kid every day. So, I love it. You're still messing with it. I love it. Absolutely. Great talent there. All right, our final grand championship of the night and our final performance of the night is the 18-plus black belt weapons division. And these guys are all talented. Our first competitor coming to us, Tennessee by way of Alabama, I believe. Please give it up for Luke Williams. This is a dramatic pause for me. This is building it up a little bit. Gentlemen, that was Mr. Brett Ford. Our next competitor, by way of Kentucky, saw his brother fight earlier, Mr. Sean Vickery. Also the promoter of the East-West Karate Challenge in Madison. Charlie Vickery. Great job, sir. And last but certainly not least, excellent young man, not only on the floor competing, but also judging and contributing. Great attitude. Please give it up from Alabama, Brandon Boyer. That was officially our last championship of the night. So, to kind of close it out, I just want to officially, there was a lot of little witty things along the show. I'm thinking about what we can do, so we're going to continue to improve, we're going to continue to get better, keep hustling and doing our thing. I want to thank everybody for supporting not just us, but all of these other wonderful tournaments and sport karate in general. I want to thank all of my judges today, all of my judges in the front row, my judges that are hanging out in the backside. Please give me a round of applause. I've got all kinds of amazing people. Miss Carr, Miss Hockey Hand came up all the way from Florida simply to work her butt off all day long. You know that reason? That's super awesome. And I want to thank all of my staff, all my teammates, all my parents, my medics, and my scorekeepers. I had so many people volunteering. I'm really, really, really just I'm overcome with how much love and support everybody gave to me. So thank you so much. We appreciate you guys very, very much. I want to thank Jamie for coming on. I want to thank Jason for all his great work. I want to thank Miss Mackenzie Emery for being absolutely amazing. I'm just going to put it on her. You guys want any pictures or anything real quick before we leave the theater? She would like more than enough to love that. And I want to thank Mr. Greg Rue for all he's doing for sport karate. He's doing for the program. He's doing for the guy in Atlanta. And what he's doing for me personally as well. Thank you, sir. And again, thank everybody. And last but not least, I want to thank Ms. Kelly for everything that she's allowed me to do, helped me to do. So, she loves karate, she loves you guys, she loves the sport, she loves meeting new people. She was not a martial artist before we got together, and I've converted her. So, you know, thank you, love you, all right, appreciate it. And Brandon Baxter, thank you for all the love, all the energy, all the MCing that you did, Alvin Brown running the music, being the champion judge. So, once again, thank everybody, I appreciate you coming out. We're going to tear this stuff down and get out of here. Thank you so much for coming. We appreciate you.
Sure, why not?